Yo, what's up, guys? Welcome back to our first ever reaction. I think we've done one before, but we deleted it. I don't know. But today we are reacting to this YouTube channel called Story Time Animated. Alright, watch. I think it's about this guy that has amnesia. I've already watched it, and it seems pretty good.
Believe it or not, I had amnesia. It all started a couple of years ago when I woke up at the hospital with no memory of who I was. I remember opening my eyes and having no memory whatsoever. Imagine waking up and not even knowing your own name. But before I go deeper into this juicy story, please like and subscribe and hit that notification bell for amazing stories like this one. The doctors told me they had found me on the side of the road with a crack in my skull. A passerby called an ambulance, and I was immediately taken into surgery. They said I was lucky to be alive, but that I had amnesia. I didn't know what to think. This was all so surreal. I had brief, fleeting memories of my past, like playing on a swing set or watching a movie at a cinema. I could remember how to speak English, how to count, how to do taxes, but that was it. I had no memories of faces or names or addresses. I wish I knew who I had been, what life I had had. Did I have parents who missed me? For all I knew, I could have a wife and 7 children. Were they at this second trying to find me? The doctors told me it was tricky business trying to recall lost memories, especially with amnesia as severe as mine. But they said I could try going to therapy. Over the next couple of weeks, I went to therapy and tried some exercises that were supposed to help me regain my memory. The therapist tried this hypnosis activity to try and find memories buried deep in my mind, but nothing came up. They advised me to listen to some music. Maybe that would trigger some past memory. But nothing happened. They told me to eat a bunch of food and special dishes like fish and chips or beef stew or Caesar salad. Still, nothing. They did all sorts of activities to try to trigger my memories coming back, but to no avail. I was starting to get really frustrated. Would I never get my memories back? I read a bunch of stories about people who had amnesia, and it said a lot of them never ended up getting their memories back. I was terrified. What if I remained this lost, confused man all my life? What if I never found my family? I was so scared this could become my life. Meanwhile, I had managed to get a low-end job working at a fast food restaurant, but the pay was so bad and I had to work such long hours. The customers were always so rude to me, and they hardly gave any tips. I was lucky enough to get a meal at the end of the day, but it wasn't uncommon for me to go to sleep still hungry, having not enough money to buy dinner. I was really miserable. Throughout this whole process, the doctors and nurses had filed missing person reports to try and see if someone was looking for me. But it was hard, especially since missing person reports could be lost in each state, and they had no clue where I had come from. For a few months, it went on like this. I kept waiting for a phone call to say they had found my family, that they were looking for me, but no phone call came. I continued to work at my boring job and continued going to the therapy sessions that never seemed to work. I started to think that maybe nobody from my past life was actually looking for me. Maybe they were better off without me. Now, I didn't know my name, but I was online one day when this ad came up for this new software. It said you Google yourself through facial recognition. That way, you can find all images that have your face in it. I couldn't believe my luck. This was the perfect chance. I searched myself up, and sure enough, it pinged with results. I started scrolling through the links, and I clicked on an article, but what I saw made my jaw drop. I found out I was a millionaire. This website said I owned a huge company that sold cars, and I had a bunch of properties across the world. I was rich. I also discovered I had a family, a wife, and not 7, but 3 children. I managed to find my Facebook page, and it was so surreal seeing I had this entire life, but I had forgotten all about it. I was currently living in this tiny apartment with mold on the walls and rats running about, but little did I know, I was actually a millionaire. I longed to find my family and tell them I was alive. You would think I would have regained my memories by now, but I didn't. The images of my wife and my 3 kids didn't seem to trigger anything. The memories seemed to stubbornly remain lost. I found my wife's Facebook account and sent her a message. I was using a different Facebook account. I had to make a new one with a new name since I had amnesia, and she read it straight away. I sent her this message. Hi, I think I'm your husband. Has he gone missing recently in the past few months? I have amnesia, so I lost all my memories, but I think you were my wife. I found all our photos together, and that looks like me. Please let me know if you lost your husband. Thanks. She replied with, "Get lost, creep. This is not a funny prank." I was mortified. She thought I was pranking her. I quickly started a video chat, and for a few minutes, I thought she was going to hang up on me. But then she answered the call, and she screamed when she saw my face through the screen. "I can't believe it," she yelled with tears streaming down her face. I smiled, but I didn't feel as happy as she did. I didn't know her. She was very pretty and seemed very nice, but I didn't have the memories of the man she had married. She agreed to meet up in person and help me get through this. The next day, I hopped on a plane and flew over to meet my wife and three kids. They were all so overwhelmed and were crying tears of joy, but I didn't really know what to feel. I didn't know them. Whoever I had been before, that man was gone for me. I had no memories of them. I could tell they were sad as well. Imagine finding your husband or father after you thought they were lost, but only to find they didn't remember you. But I was persistent in trying to get my memories back. I booked even more therapy sessions to try and help me, and this time I had a purpose. I had to get my memories back if I wanted a family again. Not long after, my wife called my parents and they drove over to meet us. I was living in my wife's house now, but it felt so alien to me. Anyway, I met my parents and the same thing happened. They were so happy to see I was alive, but I didn't really feel excited about seeing them because I didn't remember them. But then what happened next changed everything. My parents told me I had a brother as well, and we were sitting in the living room at the time. They said they thought it was best to introduce me to family members one person at a time, so as not to overwhelm me. I was excited to know I had a brother. My parents went to go get him. I hadn't realized he was waiting in the kitchen, but when he stepped into the room, I felt my stomach drop. My eyes glanced to his face, and that's when I realized I was staring at the face of my murderer. All my memories came surging back suddenly, and that's when I realized how I had ended up on the side of the road all those months ago. My brother had tried to murder me for my money. You see, I was a millionaire, but my brother was quite poor. Of course, I gave him money whenever he needed it, but obviously he must have wanted more. He knew I had him in my will, so if I was dead, some of my fortune would go to him. It pains me to think of it now, but my brother was willing to kill me for my money. I remembered it all so clearly. We had gone on a short vacation together, just as brothers, out to the countryside. My brother suggested we go hiking in the woods, and I was happy to go. We spent a few hours trekking deeper and deeper into the forest until we came upon a hillside with a sheer drop. I remember looking over the drop thinking that was pretty dangerous for hikers when I turned around and my brother was right next to me. The look on his face, so emotionless, so deadly, still sends shivers down my spine to this day. He stepped closer and pushed me off the hill. I screamed as I fell, and I remember hitting my head against the ground hard. I blacked out. I guess after that, I must have continued tumbling down the hill before finally landing to a stop by the side of the road. My brother must have assumed I was killed, but I bet he never would have guessed I had amnesia. Back in the living room, I stood up, my face red with rage, and I started to yell at my brother. "How could you do this to me?" I shouted. My brother looked fearful suddenly, but then he quickly hid the expression. "What are you talking about?" he was pretending. I was so angry. "You are the reason I got amnesia," I said. I heard my parents and wife gasp. "What?" asked my wife in confusion. "Honey," I turned to her, all memories now flooding back, and I remembered my wife. I remembered everything. "Do you remember when my brother and I went on that hiking trip?" I asked. "Yes," she said, still confused. "Well, we were on a hillside, and all of a sudden, he pushed me. He pushed me over on purpose. And I know exactly why." I turned back to my brother with disgust. "You wanted my money. You knew I had you in my will, and you just couldn't wait until I died of natural causes, could you? You just had to have my money." What? Is this true? My mom said incredulously. My brother was breathing quickly, and he cast a glance at me. You don't deserve to be a millionaire. With those words, he launched right at me, and suddenly, he had his fingers around my throat. I think he was trying to murder me again. We tussled around for a minute, with my parents and wife screaming, trying to pull him off, until I finally managed to shove him away, and we locked him in the bathroom. My wife had called the cops, and they arrived soon after and arrested my brother. Seeing my brother had triggered my memories, and I now remembered everything.
Okay, guys, so basically what happened, they visited his brother, blah, blah, blah. He don't like his brother anymore. Thank you guys for watching. Peace out. Goodbye.